an anonymous Italian immigrant came in the early 1900s, said something like, "I came to America because I was told that the streets there were paved with gold. But when I got here, I found out three things. First, the streets were not paved with gold. Second, they were not paved at all. And third, I was expected to pave them." So Leah and I wanted to write this book because we wanted to bring evidence and long-term perspective on the immigration debate, which is often discussed and based on fear and on anecdotes rather than on facts and evidence. And so we often hear this nostalgic view that European immigrants in the past, they used to come here very successful, their children were very upwardly mobile, and this is in contrast to immigrant groups today who are not able to assimilate into the US and their children are stuck in poverty. In this research that we do over the last 15 years, we build big new data sets on millions of immigrant lives to reassess some of the common myths about immigration and the American dream over the last two centuries. To get a sense of how we collected the data, you can think about us as the curious grandchildren who search for their own grandparents, but multiply this by millions. And so, you know, Leah was searching for her own grandfather and grandparents, and I was searching for my own great uncles. I found that one of them was a junk driver. The other one was a spotter of women's silk garments in the dry cleaning industry. And then we thought, well, if we could find our own ancestors and we can find our old grandparents and great-grandparents, why can't we go buy an account in ancestry.com? And we started to search for families. We started to search for one family and two families and 1,000 families. And we automated some of these searches because we wanted to scale up the research. What we find is that the children of immigrants who grow up in low-income families are very economically mobile. In fact, they are more economically mobile than the children of US-born parents who grow up to similarly low-income families. And what's also striking is that the immigrants from countries like Dominican Republic and Mexico today are just as upwardly mobile as those children of immigrants of Danes and Swedes 100 years ago. Immigrants don't move really quickly from rags to riches. Some of them don't even come in rags. They already have skills that and work in high-skill jobs, even upon first arrivals. Others do start in rags, but they never move to riches. They continue to work in manual labor throughout their lifetime. And the other thing we talk about in the book is how culture goes both ways. So immigrants don't just assimilate to the general culture, but they also contribute to a richer and more diverse culture in the United States. So overall, what we find is that the American dream, for immigrants at least, is just as alive today as it was 100 years ago. We think that politicians often tend to take short-term view for immigrants. It tend to undermine their success. When you take a longer-term perspective and think about immigration policy in terms of generations rather than in terms of years, then immigrants are doing remarkably well.